Dragon Master is here!
Skadoosh! Noah here, taking a break from my kung fu training to prepare for the upcoming new show, Kung Fu Panda, The Dragon Knight, only on Netflix. But this is far from the first we've seen of Po. So today we're going through the extensive, butt-kicking, China-defending history of everyone's favorite dragon warrior. This is the Kung Fu Panda timeline. Baby Po. Po starts life as a normal panda, raised by two loving parents in the panda village, but before he can even start forming proper memories, the village is raided by the dastardly Shen. Po's father, Li, stays behind to distract the peacock, while his mom flees with the infant into the woods, only to be ambushed by wolves. His mother has no choice but to hide Po in a nearby crate of radishes to sacrifice herself in order to save her son. The baby panda is soon discovered by local chef Mr. Ping, who decides to raise the panda as his son and restaurant protege. Kung Fu Panda, Secrets of the Scroll. The real start of the story is when Po first falls in love with the art of Kung Fu. Po is initially determined to enter the family trade. He really loves food after all, and he's not terrible at cooking, until he accidentally goofs up an order for the nearby Jade Palace, poisoning Master Shifu, the current main line of defense for the Valley of Peace at large. The timing couldn't be worse, as the super aggressive boar is currently on a warpath towards the valley. Po feels terrible, and writes a list of potential new careers. Shifu tasks his apprentice, Tigress, with gathering warriors to fight in his stead, but this list gets swapped with Po's, and everything is horribly misinterpreted. Tigress rounds up a comedian monkey, Dr. Mantis, Cleaner Crane, and Dancer Viper. It's not a mistake, though, but rather destiny, as suggested by Master Oogway, founder of the Valley of Peace and creator of Kung Fu as a whole.
It was no accident that you found him.
These five all have natural, but unique Kung Fu ability in their own right, as explored in Kung Fu Panda, Secrets of the Furious Five, but hey, this is Po's timeline. The newly formed Furious Five swiftly and awesomely defeat Boar, with Po watching and cheering on from the sidelines. It's such an inspiring display that Po discovers his life obsession, Kung Fu. Kung Fu Panda. But that obsession with Kung Fu doesn't exactly mean practicing the martial art. More like studying, geeking out, and totally fanboying over the Furious Five. Thankfully, he's a local of the Jade Palace's village and is able to view Oogway's declaration of the new fabled dragon warrior firsthand. Everyone thinks it's going to be Tigress, as she won the tournament among the Furious Five, but Po explodes onto the scene in quite an entrance that leads Oogway pointing to the panda as the dragon warrior. The Dragon Warrior is a master of Kung Fu and is the only individual allowed to unlock crazy amounts of power by reading the Sacred Dragon Scroll. Shifu does not have time for this tomfoolery. After all, Oogway just declared that the biggest threat to the valley, former student Tai Lung, is about to escape from prison. He's determined to make Po quit so they can move on and find the real Dragon Warrior and properly defend the valley. But as I said, Po is obsessed with Kung Fu, and this is absolutely a fanboy's dream come true. And only Tigress really despises him, so he's definitely not about to quit overnight. Po is quite terrible at Shifu's brand of traditional Kung Fu, but even Shifu has to admit that Po has a lot of heart and is certainly tenacious, able to take quite a bit of punishment. And when food is on the table, he displays quite an incredible amount of athleticism. After his master Oogway transcends to the spirit realm, Shifu eventually realizes he's being narrow-sighted, and that Po's wide body of abilities has loads of Kung Fu skill in its own right. After a brief training montage, Po is ready to read the Dragon Scroll in anticipation of Tai Lung's arrival, but to everyone's shock, the scroll is blank, just a bit reflective. Po is devastated, until he learns the secret of his adoptive father's secret ingredient soup. There is no secret ingredient. Unlimited potential is not some secret ingredient, but rather the belief in something special within yourself. Po confronts Tai Lung with the confidence of the true dragon warrior, easily handling the snow leopard and fulfilling his destiny as defender of the Valley of Peace. One of his first duties? Teaching the next generation of Kung Fu aficionados, as shown in the previously mentioned Secrets of the Furious Five. During Kung Fu Panda Holiday, Po is faced with the responsibility of hosting the exclusive Winter Feast at the Jade Palace, but Po has always traditionally spent the holiday helping his dad cook for the Winter Festival. It's made even worse when Po refuses any help from his friends with catering. Po is soon humbled by the overwhelming feast demands and learns that you can't do everything alone, rushing home to help dad and showing Shifu the real meaning of the holidays. Kung Fu Panda 2. Po is now a bona fide Kung Fu master and gleefully defends the valley alongside the Furious Five with flair and ease. That is, until he has a vivid flashback during an encounter with a pack of raiding wolves who bear the same sigil as the group that raided Panda Village those many years ago. This prompts Po to ask Mr. Ping where he came from, where the goose shockingly reveals that the panda is adopted.
I knew it.
Meanwhile, Shifu has tasked Po with finding his inner peace, but how can Po do that with all these questions about his past? So Po and the Furious Five head out to reclaim the fireworks stronghold. They're immediately captured, but manage to turn the tables once in Lord Shen's tower. Unfortunately, Shen's spoils of war trigger another flashback for Po, and he lets Lord Shen get away. Tigress is surprisingly understanding of Po's need for answers, but Po still foolishly confronts Shen solo. Didn't you learn anything in the holiday special? Shen manipulates Po with lies about his parents' fate, and he's soundly defeated with the peacock's cannon. Fortunately, Po lives and meets the wise soothsayer, a prophetic goat who initially predicted the downfall of Shen at the hands of a panda, the inciting incident that led to Shen's panda village raid 20 years prior. The soothsayer relays the brave and noble sacrifice of his parents to the panda. This helps Po realize that his tragic past may not have the answers that define who he is, but rather his upbringing by his loving father, Mr. Ping, and continued growth among his fellow Kung Fu masters.
Your story may not have such a happy beginning. It is the rest of your story. Who you choose to be.
With this newfound inner peace, Po returns to Gongmen City and defeats not only the evil Lord Shen, but also the unrest within his past. A bit later, during Kung Fu Panda Secrets of the Masters, Po just cannot wait for the opening of the Masters Council exhibit. He's still a huge Kung Fu nerd after all, and we love him for it. Here, Po takes the opportunity to share the tales of three Kung Fu masters, Storming Ox, Thundering Rhino, and Croc, before getting busted by Shifu and punished for breaking and entering. Kung Fu Panda 3. So Po has mastered Kung Fu and inner peace, what's next? How about unlocking his chi? Speaking of, Oogway is caught up in an epic battle in the spirit world against the historically menacing yak General Kai, who easily steals the chi of the Turtle Spirit Master. General Kai is stealing as much chi from as many Kung Fu masters as possible, living or dead, and now he's heading to the Jade Palace to steal the chi from the legendary Dragon Master himself. That legendary Dragon Master is a bit busy trying and failing to take over Shifu's duties as teacher of the Furious Five.
Did you at least learn a little something?
Yes. That you can't teach.
Po's biological father, Lee, suddenly appears back in Po's life, and it's a joyous reunion. Until General Kai attacks the valley with his jade soldiers. The only way to defeat him will be for Po to become Master of Chi, and Lee apparently just so happens to have the Mastery of Chi necessary to train his son. Po effectively abandons the Jade Palace to train with his dad in Panda Village. Things are amazing among his fellow pandas, but meanwhile the Furious Five and other Kung Fu Masters are being defeated and turned to jade minions, one by one. Once Tigress relays just how dire the situation has become, Po demands his biological father teach him to master Chi. But Lee has lied.
Because I don't know it!
Only claiming Chi knowledge to get his son away from danger. He feels terrible. But fortunately, Mr. Ping helps Lee realize he was just being a dad. And Lee rallies Panda Village to help his son fight General Kai. Turns out, Po can be an amazing teacher, especially when understanding the unique skill sets and limited attention spans of his fellow panda brethren. Po sacrifices himself to take Kai back to the spirit world, but his friends are finally able to use their chi to help Po unlock his immense chi potential, truly defeat Kai, and return to the valley victorious, where he can use his newfound chi teaching skills to better the world at large. Kung Fu Panda, the Dragon Knight. And with all that valley saving under his belt, it's finally time for Po to travel that better world. On what else but a food tour? First stop is Wang Kun Village, to sample Pei Pei's House of Fat Gobs. Wang Kun is the home of the Wu Gao Gauntlet. Naturally, the village gets raided. And naturally, Po kind of makes things worse, allowing most of the gauntlet to get away with thieves Veruca and Klaus. At least the thumb was retrieved by Po, but it kinda has a mind of its own. Po's gotta make things right, and hunt down Veruca and Klaus to retrieve the rest of the Wu Gao Gauntlet. Hunting down Veruca and Klaus just so happens to be the same goal as Luthera of Landreth, the Wandering Blade, a knight of England who definitely doesn't want Po's help on her quest to avenge her brother. This odd couple is sure to have plenty of adventures in Kung Fu Panda, The Dragon Knight, only on Netflix. That's a heck of a lot of skadooshing. And the action just keeps continuing with Po and the Wandering Blade. Stay tuned to Netflix After School for more videos on Kung Fu Panda, The Dragon Knight, and for more videos on all of your other favorite Netflix animated shows. My name is Noah. Thanks for watching.